Jesus says, stop worrying about how you can add to what God has given you. You can't even add, he calls it a cubit, which is the smallest piece of measure. You can't even add that much to yourself. So why are you worrying about everything else? I'll sleep all night because I was worried about something. Okay, back to verse 25 of our lesson. So don't put no heavy thought for your life. Don't give it no deep consideration, research, and pondering it and all that kind of stuff. Do not do it. Verse 26, behold the fowls of the air. And he says, look at the fowls of the air, the birds of the air. He said that because of where he was geographically, it was known for a lot of birds. Bird life. Great over there. He says, now how about a bird? This is where a lot of folks get tripped up. Look at the birds in the air. Look at the birds in the air.
Ooh, look at this color.
Well, they do not do what? True or false?
What's true or false? Are you asking if it's true?
Told you. I knew there was no story for this. Behold the fowls of the air, for they sow. Sow means what? S-O-W? Definition?
Plant.
Okay. Not. Neither do they reap. So they don't work. And they don't go gather up or get profits, go gather returns and all that. Is that true? True or false? Why everybody say true or is your life?
In a man's world, that would be true, but in a bird's life, that would be false. Because they do. They supply, you know, for their hunt, storehouse, you know, field nests, store food for their young.
See, Jesus would have made this a, it's all right, brother, Jesus would have made this a whole lot easier. He said, look at the ants.
And they work.
They made it a whole lot easier. Look at the ants. But he says, look at the birds. And he says, they sow not and they reap not. But, hello, Jesus, let me go out here in my backyard.
Little sow
mean
plant? So they don't plant.
Well, but they plant it to their young life. Like provided for. Mm-hmm. He sends one over here to get twigs from this over here and fly back over here and feel in the nest.
And then go reap, go get. They receive.
Same thing.
Let me see. Somebody's getting it. Bird's getting something from somewhere. And it's another bird's probably what? Bringing it to them. So, see how many of y'all see. So, when you get to preaching this hall and all of you. All right, what are we talking about here?
I want to take issue with that.
Okay,
I think. In context, Jesus was talking to them in terms of them being farmers, the sowing and the reaping. And when you look at the birds, if you take it from a literal standpoint, they don't. From a literal standpoint, it depends on how you're looking at it. But I think he taught in parables, and he taught them so that they could get the concept of sowing and reaping. Get the concept as opposed to the literal translation.
That's how stories
brother get together.
I got a thing for you. You know, like that sowing and reaping. Okay, in human life, sowing and reaping is plant and harvest. Okay, so the bird don't plant and don't harvest. Of course, they. Their own food. Wow. Now they do plant it to their little ones, right?
Hallelujah.
And if you ever notice how birds, when they go down, they eat different seeds, and when they fly over and they drop their waste there, plant.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because the seeds itself are built.
Right.
You know, you see stuff growing.
How did they get in my garden?
Bird nest.
Out of my car.
I don't think that's what you're talking about here. They're giving them on like they can't do what man does.
Oh, there you go.
I think the concept was that they don't worry about it. They don't worry about it.
I think that's inherited in the school.
Yes. Right.
They don't worry about it because in the next sentence there clarifies it. Yet your heavenly Father feedeth them.
Uh-huh.
In other words, they're not, and they're. In other words, they're saying he is the source.
Mm-hmm.
He feedeth them. He is the source. He's our source.
They got birds got to live, though. And they say the God of creation will make sure that we live. But they do. They hustle. If you ever watch a bird, he is hustling all day long until the sun, from what, sun up? Sundown. He's hustling, hustling, working while he can. Now, in the Christian world,
if the birds are hustling from sun up to sundown, then this scripture could not be referred to, you know, that in terms of them not sowing or reaping. If you took it for that
But what birds?
Well, he told us to look at the birds.
The way God, that he's saying is, what birds do is just a natural. That's the natural thing for them. That's automatic. They don't know no other way. That's just automatic. But men have a choice. And I think that's where the difference is.
Okay.
Man is taught to do the thing. Birds just come natural. And then you know, the baby birds watch and learn. But man has to teach this guy.
And the birds are doing that whole deal all day long just so they can take it back to the baby.
They just nothing, just do it.
So they can take it back to the baby. But the birds got to have a, let's say, a source. But they still going to work. They're not worrying, but they're working.
They don't work because they're just instinct. They just do it.
Yeah. You know? So if you've been reading the scripture and said birds don't do nothing, and they just, they got their own welfare, I guess. I know the number down there or something. I don't know. A lot of humans take that. Don't be like the bird. Don't do that.
But man, God's supplied for man just as well. But if man don't go out there and get it, he will starve them.
And yeah,
but birds, no,
nah, he'll starve to death too if he don't go out.
But they don't. It's instinct.
But they go out. Now here's so I'm gonna take the position that you should. And the Bible says if you don't work, you don't want. You don't need to be eating. So I'm gonna take it like this: that no matter how much we hustle, and how much energy we put into our enterprise, and what we do, whether we're gonna succeed at that enterprise or not. God is going to do what?
Take care of you.
If you are His. A lot of times we put our life into our what? W-O-R-K. And if I don't make it at this, and this school degree, or this field, or whatever it is, life is over with. So here's Jesus is telling you, God's going to take care of you no matter what, because you are His. All that working, it's okay. Yeah, work. You got supposed to. But don't be worried about if I'm going to be what? Be a success or a failure. And if it do hit the bottom and the economy goes down and up and we're in the Bush recession, now it's the Obama recession. Now we got a double dip that and all that. We listen to this all day long. Oh, Lord.
That's the main key, Brother Donnell. A lot of people say, hey, oh, it's bad out here, you know.
All day long.
Yeah. It's not bad for me. You know, it might be bad for you, but it's not bad for me. And I hear it all day long, from the rich to the poor to whatever.
Yes,
I hear it all day long.
All day long. And you say,
what's your number of perceptions?
Say, God's gonna, it don't bother me at all, it don't.
God's gonna take care of you no matter what is going on.
And I tell that all the time.
Yeah, God's gonna take care of you. God is taking care of you. Whether you in this enterprise doing good or bad, over there doing good or bad, or whatever it is, and that has had nothing to do with your heavenly Father.
That's right.
But we get locked in and think, man, I gotta make it here. You don't know. That's why I said, sometimes God feed me, I don't know where it came from. How it got here. Just thank you, Lord.
Until you pray and don't worry, or worry and don't pray.
That's right. Because worry ain't gonna make it happen. Worrying ain't gonna make it happen. I used to tell my kids get hurt, I taught them how to not worry. So we used to bump their head and scars and scratches. Oh, God! And I would say, is that helping? Yeah, look at me. You don't need me if that's helping. I don't know how that helped. Let's stop. Let's go see what we can do to make it better. All right, here we go. Verse 26 again. Behold, the fowls of the air. Look at those birds, for they don't sow not, neither do they reap, nor gather into barns. Should your heavenly Father feed them? Are you much more? Are you much better than they? That's the question. Are you much better than they? Now, which of you, by taking thought, can add one cubit unto his stature? Which of you, by taking thought, by thinking about it, giving it deep consideration, lots of study? I am, Brother Beauty, 6 foot, how many?
6 foot even.
6 foot even. He wants to be 6 foot one. He could have made it to the NFL. So he's going to do his best to get to 6'1". How many of you can add one cubit unto his stature? And a cubit is only 18 inches. So how many of you can increase your height?
Well, Brother Donnell, I can tell you this.
Okay.
It seems that Japan or China, the women were having their bones cut. Have extensions.
Really?
Metal extensions put in. You know, 2 or 3 inches so they can be tall. Yeah, that's amazing.
That's drastic.
That's amazing. Yeah.
They told me if I straighten my legs out, I'll be over 6 feet. That's all right. It's all right. I'll deal with this. So we just trying to, and it's all the cosmetic surgery, yeah. All kind of stuff going on these days. So he throws it out there to him. Which of you can do it? And so he says, since you can't do it, since you can't add to yourself. So he says, so why take ye thought? And thought is consideration, deep thinking, pondering it, and you figure it out. Why are you sitting up? I'm dealing with that. So why take ye thought for what? Clothing. I'll take ye thought for clothing. Consider the who of the field?
Yes.
The lilies of the field, how they do what?
Grow.
Now, this is God's creation, and the lilies of the field has one job. That job is to decorate the earth. How many of you be up on a plane and as you start descending, you see how beautiful it is? All the different colors. Yeah. And new sunflowers. Wow. I'm right up to them and they're the same thing. We got the purple weeds and all like that. Oh, look how pretty they are. It's just to decorate the earth. That's their job. How they grow. They don't toil. They just pop up every year. Here they go. There they are. Boom. Or not, neither do they spin, but as I consider them, I give deep thought to them, I see that, man, they just laid back and life just happens. And then after a while, they have such a short life is over. They ain't spending no time in worrying. Believe it or not, guys, we're here and life is what? Going. One reason why I spend a lot of time with my grandkids. I'm here and then one day I'll be what? I want them to say, oh, that old granddad was pretty good. We had a lot of fun. But if I wait till they get 18, 26, 30, I'm what was your name again? Whose kid were you? So, I have no concerns about them. Okay. And then he says, now, where in the Bible does he tell us how arrayed, how decked out Solomon is? There is there is no place to show how he dressed, how fabulous he was.
Even though he had a lot of money.
Even though he had a lot of money, he had it all going on. And, everything was great. Everything else was fabulous. So he wasn't running around in no rags. Solomon was decked out. You can believe it. And Jesus said this indicating himself. Solomon was dressing. And for the story that. Then Travis can come in after me, Curtis. you think Curtis can put it together, come out, step out? You should have seen the sign. Or brought attention to himself. He stepped out. So here's what we say here. Jesus says, I say unto you, even Solomon, in all his glory, was not arrayed, was not decorated like one of these. The lilies of the field, the plants of the field, they just make earth so outstandingly beautiful. And that's what you call music. That's what you call outstanding. You heard about Solomon, you can't match that. So, and he says, now, what I'm trying to say, that's what he says, wherefore. What I'm trying to say, oh, we do. If God so does what? God so clothed the grass of the field. Now, the grass of the field is that we wind up burning it. Once it dries out, we feed it to the cows. We have beautiful plant life for a while. Now, after it's over with, we're going to feed it and burn it to somebody, you know, get rid of it. That stuff is awesome. God is providing for you. He called the grass of the field, which today is, tomorrow, in the oven. And then he kind of talks about them a little bit. What does he get on them about? You ain't got no faith. You ain't got no faith. Well, I was up all night praying about this. He called Brother Williams, can you join me in prayer? Brother Williams was going to say, well, I ain't worried about this, but you want me to join in your worry. I'm going to come back to sleep. Sit up all night worrying. I'm going to be like Jesus in the what? In the boat. I'm going to go to sleep. You call it, Williams, don't you care if I perish? Yeah, but I'm going to sleep right there. It's time to go to sleep. So he says, O ye of what? The whole difference in that, the whole deal is that you've got a little faith in your provider. And there's some things that you can tell if you have faith or not. I mean, there's some markers that you can tell. I like to call it some tracks you can lay down. There's some tracks that you can determine that. Am I walking in faith or what? I'm walking in work. See if I can get those out to you in just a little bit. But He says there, therefore take no thought, verse 28, verse 31.
Therefore take no thought, saying, what should we eat, or what should we drink, or wherever should we be clothed?
Don't be over concerned. Don't be getting any thoughts into it. So now, that does not mean, and you guys know, don't make provisions. But some people are not so sure of their careers, enterprises, or what have you. If it doesn't hold up, if I fail at this, now what? If I get laid off too early, now what? If I retire too early, now what? You know, if Junior got to go to college, oh, now what? we got to go to the hospital, oh, Lord, health insurance, now what? They deal with it every day. Mm-hmm. If this real stuff happens and it goes to the negative, now what? If I lose my job, now what?
You know, Brother, some people just weird.
Yeah.
And you have to kind of.
I got some relatives. I'm going to say which side they are on, mine again.
Yeah. Yes. You have to tune them out.
You have to tune them out?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because she popped up. She must be which side of family. Folks, just worry. Got to find a reason to give some thought to something. Got to put some thought into that. Okay, so if you look at Ephesians, yeah, the second chapter, verse 11, and if you sold out on here, you won't have any, if you know who you are in Christ, mm-hmm. you won't be having that, all those deep concerns about stuff. Ephesians 2. And 11. Mm-hmm. All right. So we'll read that if you will. Read verse 10.
And we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus unto good works, which God has before ordained that we should walk in them.
Mm-hmm.
Wherefore remember that ye being in time past Gentiles in the flesh, who are called uncircumcised by that which is called the circumcision in the flesh made by hands.
And verse 12.
That at the time you were without Christ, being aliens from the commonwealth of Israel and strangers from the covenant of promise, having no hope and without God in the world.
Okay, that's the key right there. Having no hope and without God in the world. Now, right now, we readily confirm that we are with God. God is with us in this world. It doesn't make any difference what my employment status, business statute, or anything else. It doesn't matter about that. God is God regardless of what I do. Mm-hmm. You know, sometimes I might be in the wrong profession for 30 years. So I'm thinking I'm doing good and, you know, everything's so good. That has nothing to do with God. And then, most of the enterprises and professions we're in ain't got nothing to do with provisions coming from God. Now, he just blesses you because he blesses. He's that kind of guy. He just blesses. And if you got laid off early, retired early, forced out, whatever, inside, downsized, all kind of ways they do it these days, tell you to get out, hit the street. Don't worry. You know, God is still God. And he's God of the world. And I'm his child in this world. Now, there was a time that I would probably have some serious worry. Had to worry. That was before I was what, in Christ. So, there we go there. Now, the way you can tell, and there may be some tracks following you showing unbelief, is you start acting like you did before you got saved. Let's see. Some preacher come through here, sister, they call them, they call it fleece. Oh,
Please.
Yeah, please hang out.
Please.
I forgot we were preaching.
Some in the north side?
Yeah, I'm preaching on that. Hang out a please. To see if God coming this way, if this is you, then give me a sign. But the Gentiles seek after, you heard it in the Bible, Gentiles seek a sign. The Greeks seek, look for a sign. Everybody else walks by faith. Okay, now before you got saved, you were into, if I bought a newspaper today, 35, 36 years ago, the first section I would turn to would be the horoscope. And I can determine how my day is going to go. I ain't got to worry about God and nobody else.
And you believe that?
You think there's belief in that?
I don't. Witchcraft to me.
So before you got saved, when I got in the war, that was your system. Come on my way to church, and on my way home from church every day, look it over to the north, west, bright lights. $5 might give me $5,000, Mr. Hill. Huh? Back in the day. I might just go over there and roll me a dice or two. That's how you money out. Take a chance. That's when you know you're laying down markers as to are you really believing or not. Back in, I don't know if some of you guys might not remember your grandparents or elders played the policy wheel. Policy wheel. Gotta go see if the wheel's gonna be in my favor. It's a form of illegal gambling from the residents. So there's some things that you can track yourself and say, man, I hope I'm not stepping back into those deals again. You know, why not getting close? It's all the way from medicine to all of the landscape of things that can make life better for you. All you got to do is just step in. So now, so you have to be careful. That way you don't get into superstition and speculation. Because life will kind of make you, if you don't have God in your life, strong faith in your life, you kind of lean over it. Let's see, Black Friday. Kill each other over Black Friday. God will never give me enough money to buy a flat screen TV. There's one for $200. Get out of the way. Stand up all night for that thing. I'll shoot you to get it out of the way. Brother said, I'm going to sleep tonight, and I'll go pay an extra $200 to get it. Come on. My sleep, my peace is worth $200. Well, I'm moving $200. I ain't getting out there in that cold waiting on no television. I'll pay $600 for it straight up noon.
Or you believe that God has one for you somewhere that you're right. Yeah. That you don't have to pay $600.
The economy ain't getting to me.
Yeah.
I don't need the discount to lose my sleep over. Well, there goes retail. So take no thought, saying what you should eat or what should we drink. Stop worrying about it. For all these things, verse 32, who seek after that?
Gentile
means non-believers. Pagans. Pagans. People that are into superstitions and speculation in life. Those are the ones who are into worry about all that kind of stuff. People get paid to go straight to the casino or what have you. And want some kind of way to make this dollar go another day. The Gentiles seek. For your Heavenly Father know that you have need of what? All these things. When you can buy into the fact that my Father knows that I see that need. If I see it, he probably saw it a long time ago before I saw it. I'm not going to worry about it. Needs, I don't know, it was a drop of sleep over.
I think that even if someone says, if the cupboards be empty, mountains shake, fall in the sea, that's just a, wow, awesome event. Earthquake shook the other day in Oklahoma and everybody was in the church. Start holding revival. Time's time for revival. Herb's shaking. Okay, all right, okay. Okay. Gentiles seek a what? A sign. Now here's the key right here, verse 33, so we run out of time. He says, but seek. What do we mean by that? Seek ye first the kingdom of God. Seek ye first the kingdom of God. Seek ye first the kingdom of God. Someone will give me your perspective. No, I was making it worse.
Put your faith in God first.
Okay.
Put your trust in God. Go to God first.
That's the word first. That's the deal. Make God your high priority. Mm-hmm. That's your top priority in all things is God, your Heavenly Father. Consider His ways as your top priority. And then it says, and His righteousness, which means that make sure you have put on what He has available for you. Because it says, that's 1 Corinthians 1 and 30. That's what He made you, His righteousness. And it's not effective for you unless you are wearing it. So